إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم. ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين. يخادعون الله والذين آمنوا وما يخدعون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون. في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا ولهم عذاب أليم بما كانوا يكذبون.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير for coming and we ask Allah bless you and we ask Allah make it easy for me and you and we ask Allah make us real believers, real mu'min, and we ask Allah عز وجل by His great name to save us from الرياء, the show off, and from النفاق, hypocrisy. Say Ameen. Our topic now about النفاق, the hypocrisy, and the categories of hypocrisy. As I told you the last halakha before, that hypocrisy, or in Arabic, try to know the word in order to, I will repeat the word Arabic, nifaq. And the one who is having nifaq, having the hypocrisy, he is himself munafiq. Munafiq, the person, man or a woman. The nifaq itself is a hypocrisy. The hypocrite is a munafiq, the person. The hypocrisy is the nifaq itself. What is the meaning of munafiq, or what is the definition? What the ulama said about the definition of it? This is number one. How many kind of nifaq? What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about nifaq in the Quran al-Kareem? Does the munafiq out of Islam or no? Does he become, wal'ayyazu billah, kafir or no? And when he will become kafir and when not? As I told you that this is a mu'min, opposite of it is the kafir. The one who is swaying between is the munafiq, wal'ayyazu billah. But some of the category and some of the characteristics, if he have, Allah admit him to the kuffar, to the disbelievers. Some other, if he have it and still have the adjectives of iman, somebody believing la ilaha illallah Muhammad al-Rasulullah, believe in the angel, believe in everything, but still some have some of the adjectives of munafiq. Now he is a mu'min, but his iman is weak. And he still have some of the adjective, as Rasulullah said. I'll bring the hadith to you. Whoever have one of it, he's still one of the other category. Because nifaq is two kind. Nifaq i'tiqadi, which it is the greatest one. Which is a very dangerous one. And this is the one what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Karim. Listen. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ وَلَن تَجِدَ لَهُمْ نَصِيرًا. Jahannam, worst part of it is the bottom. Jahannam itself complained to Allah about this part especially. Allah said the munafiq will be in the depth, will be in the lowest, will be in the very down, deep down part of Jahannam itself. وَالْعَيَزُ بِاللَّهِ. But this kind, the one who have nifaq, hypocrisy in his aqeedah, in his belief, and I will explain. This is just the beginning. But the other kind, it's named in nifaq al-amali. There is nifaq i'tiqadi, naqida, nifaq amali, in deeds and actions. This is the one, he's still a mu'min according to, if he believe in la ilaha illallah, believe in Muhammad Rasulullah, believe in the last day, believe in all whatever already explained about Islam and Iman and Ihsan, in the last halaqah. And still have some of the characteristics of the munafiq, he is having adjectives and having characteristics of nifaq. Rasulullah said he will have part of it and he will not a pure mu'min except if he leave it. Now, what the ulama said about the definition of nifaq? Ibn Kathir, if you go to it, قال النفاق هو إظهار الخير وإسرار الشر. There is many definition, one of it of Ibn Kathir. He said the nifaq is to openly and to appear with every good, but inside you have every evil. Openly you try to be pretend that you are a good, and you do the good deeds. The worst example of that, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, at the time of Rasulullah. He said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. And he used to pray with the believers. And he used to be with the Sahaba. And he sees a wahi to Rasulullah. At the same time, he does not believe in anything of that in his heart. There was a reason for him, but it is not acceptable. Yeah, before Rasulullah migrated from Mecca to Medina, the people of Medina was going to, especially the Jewish, was going to make him the king of Medina. When the Rasulullah came, all the people left him and they went to Rasulullah and believe in Rasulullah and become a Sahaba of Rasulullah and become a believer, become a Muslims. They left him alone. He hates that. He doesn't like that. But even with this reason, is not a reason for him to be protected. Because after that, he was going on with the same. Pretending in front of the people with the iman. And with that, he's good. And he will help. And behind and inside himself, all kind of evil. Doesn't like Rasulullah, does not like Islam, and this is the one Rasulullah and Allah saying and warning the Muslim to have any part of it, and I will explain. Because this kind of name in i'tiqadi, in aqidah, six different kinds. Ibn Juraij say, Al-Munafiq yukhalifu qawluhu is more. Ibn Juraij, he have definition little bit bigger and better. He said, Al-Munafiq yukhalifu qawluhu fi'luhu. The munafiq, always his saying different than his doing. He say something and he do something else. His saying always will be different. And when he do, he will say opposite of what he do. He do wrong, they'll say, no, I didn't do. I was doing right. يُخَالِفُ قَوْلُهُ, whatever he say, opposite of what he do. وَيُخَالِفُ سِرُّهُ عَلَانِيَتُهُ. وَيُخَالِفُ سِرُّهُ عَلَانِيَتُهُ. His appearance and his hidden is different than each other. Whatever in front of the people something, whatever inside his heart and his mind, completely opposite of that. وَيُخَالِفُ مَدْخَلُهُ مَخْرَجُهُ. The literal meaning, which is not accurate, but I hope if you understand it, that his entrance different than his exit, which it is not exactly like that. For anything he deal with, you will find him when he start with something and when he try to enter to this thing, he will do some way, a crooked way to enter to this thing. When he try to get out of it, he will get out of the different thing. وَيُخَالُفُ مَشْهَدُهُ مَغِيبُهُ. Whatever in front of the people is something, whatever is hidden and whatever the unseen from the people is something else. Because he does not believe in Allah. If he believe in Allah, he will not do that. He does not believe if Allah so see him in front of the people and see him if he's alone. The most important, وَيُخَالِفُ قَلْبُهُ لِسَانُهُ. His heart completely different than his tongue. يُعْطِيكَ مِنْ طَرْفِ اللِّسَانِ حَلَاوَةً وَيَرُوغُ مِنْكَ كَمَا يَرُوغُ الثَّعْلَبُ. He will give you from his tongue very beautiful word. But from his heart, completely opposite of what he say. And completely hate you and he doesn't like you. For that, nifaq is a two different kind. In aqidah, which it is the greatest one, which is the most dangerous one, which it is the whole warning of the whole ayat of the Quran and a lot of ahadith in the sunnah, warning against this kind. And I will explain the six category of it. And this is the one, if anyone have any part of it, he will be in Jahannam forever. And this is the one who will get out of Islam. Remember at the beginning, I said, if the munafiq, does the munafiq stay Muslim as a Muslim or he get out of the circle of Islam? If he have one of the aqidah, nifaq, the greatest one, and I will explain, that he will be getting out of Islam. The other one, it's named the amali one, the deeds in action. Nifaq, but in deeds in action. And this one is smaller than the other one. And it is greater than any kind of sin other than shirk. Greater than all kind of sin. It is one of the major sin and does not get him out of Islam. This is very important to know, and I will come with a also comparative between the greatest one and the smallest one. This is does not get him out of Islam. But he's still in a very dangerous way, because the smallest one, it could lead him to the greatest one. Now let us go with one by one and step by step, and we'll go more for more, inshallah, because I prepared for you a lot of it. Nifaq in aqidah, which it is in belief, which it is in the faith, and this is the one Allah says that he will get out of Islam, and he is in the lowest and the deepest part of Jahannam, have six different types. And its adherent will be among the lowest and depth level people in hellfire. Number one, inkaru aw takdhibu ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To be lie or to deny Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You say that he is not the last of the messenger. This is very important. You say now he is not the last one. For that inkar, denying or belying Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is one. Number two, inkaru aw takdhibu ba'du ma ja'a bihi ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He does not deny him completely, but he denies some part. To belie or deny some or part of which Rasulullah has brought to the mankind. Example, he denies the Quran. He believes in Rasulullah, but said no Quran. He believes in Rasulullah and he loves him, but said no sunnah. I believe in Quran only, no sunnah, like some people now. There is nothing that's named sunnah. Astaghfirullah. He believes in Rasulullah, but he denies some, like some of the law of Islam does not come to his mind. He does not like it. Some of the principle of Islam, no, I don't like this one. I don't believe in it. This will be very dangerous. This is the one will get him out of Islam. Denying Rasulullah completely or partially. Also number three, bughdu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To hate Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is part of it. Or bughdu ba'd ma ja'a bihi Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To hate some of that which was brought by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like somebody hate tawheed. He loved to be mushrik. This is what Allah will get him out of Islam if we keep believing in it. Also, he said, I love Islam, but I hate that he makes the wine is haram. Either you accept all of it or you are rejecting all of it. Do not deny even part of it. Somebody saying, yes, I believe and I like him and I don't hate him, but I like the salah. I don't want it. It's too heavy. And five times a day, this is also will get him out of Islam. Number five of the category, which it is the greatest one, al-masarratu bi-nkhifadu dini Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To feel happy at the disgrace of the Islam or sit back for Islam. To feel happy when the Islam become down and down, oh, this is good. Astaghfirullah. This is nifaq. And this is the one will be in a very dangerous. Also opposite of it, he does not feel bad for feel happy to Islam to be down, but al-karahiyatu lintisari dini Rasulillah, to dislike that the religion of Allah's messenger become victorious, not being pleased at the victory of Islam. This is also kind of nifaq. And this is the one, he will be in the lowest and the deepest part. There is another two also. عدم اعتقاد وجوب تصديقه فيما أخبر به. If he does not believe in what Rasulullah says, it is not a wajib to believe in what he says. This is what A'azhu Billah nifaq also. Or عدم اعتقاب وجوب طاعته فيما أمر به صلى الله عليه وسلم. If he believes that, I love him and I don't hate him, but I will not follow him. It's not a wajib, it's not a must to follow Rasulullah. It's not a must to obey him. Astaghfirullah. This is nifaq A'azhu Billah. You have to believe and to take it as a truthful from Rasulullah what he say, and to do it. But if you denying, or you belying, or you say, I don't want to follow, وَلْعَزُ بِاللَّهِ this is nifaq. And this is what Allah said in the Quran al-Kareem, Surah al-Nisa, go to it. Al-Nisa, Ayah 145. Allah said, إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار ولن تجد لهم نصيرا. Those kind, six kind and plus two more in another category. This ones is the one like the total of eight. This is the one Allah said they will be, this munafiq, this hypocrite, they will be in the lowest depth part of Jahannam, والعياذ بالله, of hellfire. Let us move now to the second kind, النفاق العملي. The nifaq, the hypocrisy in deeds, in the deed he do, or in actions. And it is mentioned by hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Many ahadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, like if you go to the hadith in al-Bukhari, volume number 1, hadith number 34, hadith number 2459, hadith number in volume number 4, 3178, also 2682, and 2749 in al-Bukhari, and 6095. And also in Muslim, a lot, agreed upon between Bukhari and Muslim, a lot of ahadith about the category of the practical, when impractical, in the deeds and in the actions. It is five different kinds. There are five aspects of the hypocrisy in the deeds and in the actions. According to Bukhari and Muslim in Book of Iman, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, in one hadith, he mentioned three. In another hadith, he mentioned four, which he had one more. In another hadith, he mentioned another two. One of them is already mentioned in the one before and one new. That means the total is five. Number one, إذا حدث كذب. Let me say it in Arabic, then I'll translate in English. إذا حدث كذب. وإذا واعد أخلف. وإذا اؤتمن خان. These three in one hadith. In another narration. وَإِذَا عَاهَدَ غَدَر number 4 وَإِذَا خَاصَمَ فَجَر. For that, listen to me carefully to know it. And this is the one will not get him in, out of Islam, but still he is, Rasulullah said, name him pure munafiq. The signs of the munafiq are these ones. Whenever he speaks, he tells a lie. And try to think about it, you'll find a lot of Muslims who ask Allah, save us doing that. When they speak, they lie. When he promised, he break his promise. When he is interested, he proved to be dishonest. This is number three. Number one, when he speak, he lies. Number two, I'm repeating in order for everybody to know it, in order to avoid it. It was very dangerous. When he speak, he lie. For that when he speak, do not lie. Say the truth, doesn't matter what it is. When he promised, he breaks his promise. When you promise, do not break promise. This is a believer. When he is interested, he proves to be dishonest. Means, if you keep something as a trust, you know, amanat, the trust with him, he will never return it to you. Or he will never return part, another part, no. For that he, when he will trust him, the munafiq, he proves that to be dishonest. Number four, whenever he dispute, this is in another hadith, whenever he dispute or when there is quarrelsome, he behaves in a very imprudent way. He behaves in an evil way. He behaves immorally. He behaves in insulting manner. For that, the believer, even there is a dispute or not, he will try as much as he can not to be imprudent, not to be evil, not to be immoral. He will keep himself under the moral. Even they get angry. You can get angry, no problem. But control yourself at the time of anger. Do not be evil. Do not try to harm. Yes, he did so this to me, he will see. A'udhu billah, this is signs of munafiq. For that this is one of it. Insulting manner. Rasulullah himself, he get angry, but he was not insulting. He was not evil. He does not take revenge, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Except if it is in the way of Allah and must do be something, he do it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number five, when he make a covenant. Because some people in the fundraising in Ramadan, yes, 10,000, and forget about it till the day of judgment. No. When you make a covenant, it is between you and Allah. It is a covenant. He proves himself a treacherous, betrayer. want to get a credit. Yes, I will do so and so and so. Say what you are able to do. And do what you said. Say only what you are able to do. Nobody force you. And do what you already promised. For that, إذا أتى المسلم عملا من أعمال النفاق العملي من الكذب والغدر وغير فإنه لا يخرج من الإسلام. If he commit one of this, he does not get out of Islam, but Rasulullah named him, the hadith is coming, a pure munafiq. And he said, if he have one of the characteristics of this five, which every Muslim should know it, he still have one of the characteristics of the munafiq. And he will not be a complete mu'min and a pure mu'min except if he get out of it and he leave it. And he is in a great sin and in a very dangerous way. And the ulama say, we fear about the one who have that, it will lead him to al-iyazu billah, to the greatest one. That one time will deny Rasulullah or deny part of what Rasulullah bring, it will lead because it is connected to each other. Like the iman, seeds of iman will bring more iman, seeds of evil bring more evil. Right? Seeds of apple, it will bring a tree of apple. Later it will bring what? Watermelon? No, it will bring apple also. Seeds of thorn. In future, a tree of thorn. Then the seeds of thorn, more. For that, the seeds of good will bring good more and more. It will increase and make you close to Allah. Seeds of evil will make you more evil. And you will think the problem with the people who do the evil, they do not know. And they do not feel. The one who do wrong, did you think that he thinking that he's doing wrong? Swear by Allah, some of the Muslims, they do the most evil at the same time. They think that they are doing the best. Nobody helping Islam more than them. I said, A'uzu billah. This is the worst kind of going astray. Dal wa mudil. Going astray and leading the people to be going astray with him and while he doesn't know. For that Rasulullah said, the Muslim is a mirror for his Muslim brother. Like if there is a spot here, you will never see by your eye. But when you look to the mirror, some people, they will break the mirror. Instead of the clean, the wrong. For that Muslims that should be sincerely to his Muslim brother, if there is some mistake, make it clear. If you have some of that, do not come and fight me, akhi. Clean yourself. Clean yourself and try to be good and straight. This is what Allah wants you. The aqidah nifaq wal'iyazu billah will lead you to kufr. And also one of the description coming later, always the munafiq, especially who have this five, is very, very, very crooked. He tried to deceive the people. You'll find him. There is ayat coming about that. He will try to deceive the believers. Deceive them, cheat them, thinking this is the only way to get what he wants. A'uzu billah. A'uzu billah, ya akhi, from this. For that, listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Quran al-Kareem, Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4, go to Ayah number 142. Listen, Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, innal munafiqina yukhadi'un Allah, wa huwa khadi'uhum. Verily the hypocrites, munafiqin, the hypocrites seek to deceive Allah. How? They thinking that just say, I am a believer, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, this is, will go on in dunya and go on in akhirah with Allah. No, it will never. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, but it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who causes them to be deceived because of their bad intention. Listen to another description of them. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالًا. And when they stand up for a salah, they stand up with laziness. When they come to the masjid, lazy. They don't want to come. This is with the one who come. And Allah described him with this way. What about the one who does not come? Subhanallah. Remember when I told you about the salah, especially we're coming to it, that Iblis refused one sajda. Allah cursed him, get him out of al-Jannah, decide for him to be in hellfire forever. One sajda. You are ordered to do daily 34 sajda. Whoever does not breathe a 5-day prayer, he actually, without saying by tongue, practically, he is refusing the order of Allah daily 34 times. Because 34 sabda in the farad only, in the fard. Plus fajr, plus zuhr, plus asr, plus maghrib, plus isha, total 34 sajda. The sajda in the land, the one will be restrate yourself on the land. This is 34. Iblis was cursed and was getting out of al-Jannah because refusing only one. The description of the munafiq, it is heavy to them. For that, when they come, lazy. They don't want. I'll give you another example of that. You will find some of them sitting in front of something he loves, movie, or what other thing, soccer, or any kind of a computer. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 hours, no problem at all. Come to the prayer, 3, 4 ayat, Sheikh, you make it so long and make it so short, what is that? Mudham Matan, as the Sheikh Kishk, a long time ago, he is saying, one of the imams, every time say, oh, for that he read the smallest one in the Quran, smallest ayah. There is only one word in Surah Al-Rahman. Mudhammatan means it is the meaning is two green garden. The meaning of it. After the Shaykh, make it mudhamma wahda. Make it only one. Even Zaya, how we do, split it? Subhanak ya Rab. So look, this is the signs of munafiq. Munafiq, they think that they deceive Allah al-Azhu billah and they seek to do, thinking that only just by tongue is enough. And this is what I always say to the believers, to the mu'min. Go to the condition of La ilaha illallah. Is explained in another halaqat. Mean halaqa. Seven conditions of La ilaha illallah. And think about your own self. Does you have it or you do not have it? Otherwise, al-'azhu billah, you will have some part of nifa' while you don't know. When they stand to the salah, they stand with laziness. What else? Munafiq do? Yura'un an-nas. To be seen of men. They merely desire to show themselves before the people. You will find them double faces. In front of the people, so good. If he pray at the masjid and he knows people looking, Allahu Akbar. Some of the people, they turn themselves two down. What are you doing? Show off all of it. Deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same person if he pray at home, Allahu Akbar, sami' Allahu liman hamida. In half second, he finish 50 rak'ah. A'udhu billah. Do you think that you will deceive Allah? Allah watching you here and Allah watching you there. Deal with Allah Azza wa Jal. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yura'un an-nas. One of the other description coming later, inshallah, I'll explain all of this. وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. They do not remember Allah but little. They do not mention the name of Allah except a few. They do not mention the name of Allah. Look to yourself. Are you mentioning the name of Allah by any way? Subhanallah or Alhamdulillah or La ilaha illallah and repeating. Allahu Akbar and repeated. La ilaha illa anta subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin and repeated. And it is you are happy with doing or you are not. Because Allah mentioned about the munafiq. They do not mention and they do not remember Allah except little. And this little Allah knows. Maybe with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, 100 times a day is little, 200 is little. For that you should be always remember Allah. Reading Quran also. One of the way to remember Allah, to always. You do not know how to read. Learn to read it. It takes time. It's okay to take time. You learn English in order to have money. And you don't know how you don't want to learn Arabic to read Quran. You don't want to learn Arabic in order to go to Jannah. Subhanallah. Every one of us struggle to learn English. Right or wrong? And we spend a lot of years. Why do not spend these years also to learn your language of your Quran, language of your Islam, language of your Jannah, in Jannah, inshallah, and we ask Allah to admit us to it and to save us from an-nar. In the same ayah, they do not remember Allah. مُذَبْذَبِينَ بَيْنَ ذَٰلِكَ لَا إِلَهَا أُولَىٰ وَلَا إِلَهَا أُولَىٰ. Very important this point. They are swaying in between those and this, good and evil, right and wrong, halal and haram. They are in between. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, they are in between, belonging neither to those nor to this. Do you remember when I told you before? When there is the truth and the false, where you should be? Answer me, please. With the truth. When there is a light and dark, where you should be? The light. Answer. Raise your voice. When there is a good and bad, where you be? Good. Excellent, man. When you are good and evil, where you should be? Good. When right and wrong, where you should be? Right. When halal and haram, where you should be? Right. Halal. When sunnah and bid'ah, Where you should be? It's a sunnah. There is some people professional, ya akhi. In this thing between al-haqq and batil, say to you, be neutral. This problem of neutrality, you will always will come with this way. With the right and wrong, be neutral. Oh, close your eye, turn your face, do not blink to any one of them. Because you are a sheikh, you are an imam. A'udhu billah. You want me to be munafiq? Allah say, the munafiq is they are swaying. They are wavering between the two sides. They do not belong to this one, they do not belong to this one. When there is a right and wrong, be with the right. If you think that I will be in between, I'm not with the right, and I'm not against it, and I'm not with the wrong, and I don't belong in it, no. Allah already make you with the munafiq. And where is the munafiq? With the believer or they are munafiq? They are munafiq. That means you belong to the other side. If it is right or wrong, and you think that you are in between, you are with the wrong. Well, you don't know. If it is al-haq and al-batil, truth and false, right and wrong, light and dark, and you think that you are in between, firstly, this is nifaq, hypocrisy. This is a hypocrisy. Be neutral. No, there is no neutrality in these things. Maybe there is neutrality in other, especially with the politics. But with the Islam and with Allah and with Rasulullah and with the truth and right and the false, with the right and wrong, with the light and dark, with the correct and wrong, and with sunnah and bid'ah, there is no, you have to be with the right. Do not be with the wrong. And if you think that you are in between and you don't want to be belong to anyone, you are hypocrite. You are munafiq. And actually you belong to the other side, to the wrong. You belong to the false. You belong to the evil. You belong to the bid'ah. You belong to the whole kind of wrong. Instead of halal and haram, you cannot between. You have to be with the halal. Impossible to be in between, otherwise you are with the haram. Because there is no way, either halal or haram. There is no in Islam or in between. Except in very, very, very few cases. Like suppose you are in a desert and there is a dead. It's forbidden for you, this is haram. But it is allowed now because of the necessity. And allowed by the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. For that here, other than this, all the others, no. This is what Allah described. They are wavering between the two sides, belonging neither to this nor to those. Wal'ayazu billah. Allah said, وَمَن يُضْلِلِ اللَّهِ فَلَن تَجِدَ لَهُ سَبِيلًا. And whom Allah sends astray, whoever Allah let him to go astray, you will never find for him any way to the truth. You will never find for him any way to be guided. Some people of this is very clear, nifaq. And when you talk to him, Ya Rabbi. Some of them, they come to me myself and say, Shaykh, compromise. Wallahi, he says, Subhanallah. I said, brother, it is here very clear, right, and this is the Quran of Allah and Sunnah of Rasulullah. And this is shaitanic way. This is Allah's way, this is shaitan way. How I compromise? Oh, you are sheikh, you are imam. You have to lead the people. Lead the people by the wrong. How? Lead the people to the right. Imam is to be followed. إِنَّمَا جُعْلَ الْإِمَامُ لِيُؤْتَمَّ بِهِ. Imam is not to follow the people according to their desire. The imam himself must follow Quran and Sunnah and lead the people to the Quran and Sunnah. And everybody have to agree for that. For that here, listen to Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 1, hadith number 34, and hadith number also repeated in al-Bukhari itself 6 different times, in al-Bukhari, and with a different ways. Abdullah ibn Umar, another one by Aisha also, that Rasulullah s.a.w. said, أَرْبَعُ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ كَانَ مُنَافِقًا خَالِصًا. Wherever has the following four characteristics, will be a pure munafiq. This is in this hadith. As I told you, the total is 5. Because of the other hadith. Listen to the point I bring this hadith especially. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ فِيهِ خَصْلَةٌ مِّنْهُنَّ كَانَتْ فِيهِ خَصْلَةٌ مِّنَ النِّفَاقِ حَتَّى يَدَعَهَا. And whosoever has one of the following four characteristics, any one of them, listen, will have one of the characteristics of nifaq, of hypocrisy, unless and until he gives it up. Unless and until he gives it up. Unless and until he leaves it. and listen until he knows that he is sick. He has some sickness. And he has to treat himself to stop it. What it is, Ya Rasulullah, is a tumina khan. In this hadith start with, whenever he isn't trusted, he betray, he proves it is honest. Number two, إذا حدث كذب, whenever he speaks, he tells a lie. Number three, وإذا عاهد غدر, whenever he makes a covenant, he proves to be treacherous. Treacherous means betrayer. وإذا number four, وإذا خاصم فدر, whenever he quarrelsome, he behaves in a very imprudent, evil, and insulting manner. For that, these four, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said what? If he have these four, he is a pure munafiq. If he have one, he still one have one of the characteristics of the hypocrisy, and he will be considered as a munafiq until and unless he leaves it and he be far away from it. Is there tawbah for the munafiq or the hypocrite? Yes, Allah mentioned Quran al-Kareem, Surah An-Nisa, verse number 145. And this I want to already read. Munafiqeen will be in the lowest and the deepest and the worst part of Jahannam, hellfire. And you will never find any helper for them. Listen. Listen. Except who? Ayah number, Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 146. Except who? Listen. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا. Not only tawbah. وَأَصْلَحُوا. I will explain. وَأَصْلَحُوا. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا. وأصلحوا واعتصموا بالله وأخلصوا دينهم لله فأولئك مع المؤمنين فأولئك مع المؤمنين وسوف يؤتي الله المؤمنين أجرا عظيما. Listen carefully to know that Allah says they will be in the worst and the deep depth and the lowest and the hardest عذاب and torture in the lowest part in Jahannam, except those who do tawbah and repent and they give up and they stop these characteristics of the munafiq, the five of them, and also if they have al-azab of the greatest ones, there is no doubt. You have to leave it completely. Number two, وَأَصْلَحُوا. They do righteous good deeds. The tawbah itself is not enough. You have to do righteous good deeds. Why? Because he was doing evil deeds. For that, you have to do righteous good deeds. Allah means this in Quran. An-Nisa, go ayah 146. After he do tawbah, must do good deeds. Not only that. Number three of the condition. وَاَعْتَصَمُوا بِاللَّهِ. He have to be hold fast with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if he does not hold fast with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is holding fast with opposite of Allah is shaytan wal-a'azu billah. If iman is kufr or nifaq wal-a'azu billah. Or show of riya. For that, وَاَعْتَصَمُوا بِاللَّهِ, hold fast with Allah, means he become a very straight mu'min and believer. Number four, وَأَخْلَصُوا دِينَهُمْ لِلَّهِ, purify their act of worship to the sake of Allah only. Purify their act of worship sincerely for the sake of Allah only. For that, how many conditions a munafiq have to do? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be merciful to him and he think about to do tawbah. Tawbah, doing righteous good deeds, hold fast with Allah and follow Him, follow the Quran and Sunnah strictly, and make your good deeds sincerely for the sake of Allah only. Purify your intention and purify your act of worship, any kind of ibadah, as I told you about the ibadah last time, for the sake of Allah only, sincerely to Him. Listen, Allah said, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. After all of these four, tawbah and do righteous good deeds, and hold fast with Allah, and make sincerely everything sincerely for the sake of Allah, they will be with the mu'mineen. They will be admit to the believer. Means before that, where are they? Are they with the believer? Answer me. No. And this is a big warning. Allah say, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. After this, after he do tawbah and good deeds and hold fast with Allah and make sincerely everything for the sake of Allah, now he become with the believer. فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Means before that, if he does not and he does not success to do it, where are he? Where he step? With the non-believers, wal-a'azu billah. Because he's a munafiq, wal-a'azu billah. Allah said, وَسَوْفَ يُؤْتِ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. And Allah will give the believer a very great reward. In al-Bukhari, volume number 8, hadith number 6058, and repeated also 7,179 and 3,494 that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, and this hadith repeated many times with a different ways, تَجِدُ مِنْ شِرَارِ النَّاسِ وَفِي رِوَيَةٍ إِنَّ مِنْ أَشَرِّ النَّاسِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ ذَا الْوَجْهَيْنِ الَّذِي يَأْتِي هَؤُلَاءِ بِوَجْهٍ وَهَؤُلَاءِ بِوَجْهٍ. The worst people before Allah on the day of the Qiyamah, on the day of resurrection, and the last day, will be the double-faced one. Double-faced people who appear to some people with one face and to another people with another face. Appear with some people. If he comes with the believer, he will be so believer. If we come with the kuffar, he will be worse than them. This is what Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says. The worst people in front of Allah at the day of judgment will be the double-faced people who appear to some people, like the believer, with one face, good face. They pray, it's okay, I'll pray with them. Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. وما أكثر عبد الله ibn Ubay ibn Salul. Another thing also, be careful. Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul have a son, his name, Rasulullah named him also Abdullah. For that there is two Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul is the father, this is the munafiq one. And there is Abdullah ibn Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, his son, this is the believer one. He was good. For that when you're reading, be careful which one you are talking about. For that here, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, double face. With the Jewish and with the enemy of Rasulullah and with Abu Sufyan before he became Muslim and with anyone who wants to go for war against Rasulullah, he was with them 100%. And he was supporting them and helping them and giving them the news of Rasulullah. And with the believer and in front of his son, he used to hide the things from his son. He used to help Huyay ibn Akhtab. And this is the worst enemy to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Go read the history of Islam and you will know. Every Muslim should know it. He used to help him in front of his son, in front of the Sahaba. Yes, you are going for war, I'm coming. And all of my followers will come with you. For that, this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. There is also many other examples. This is a great one, big one. But there is examples that double-faced a lot. Inshallah, we ask Allah by His great name to make us pure mu'min. Say ameen. And to save us from nifaq. Say ameen. Ameen. And to save us from also show off. Ameen. And make us sincerely to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next time, we'll go with more and more and more about al-nifaq and about the dangers of it and about one thing very important, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about hypocrisy and said about the hypocrite people. This is some of the description, but there is still a lot more. Believe me, a lot. A lot of ayat in the Quran, especially in Surah Al-Baqarah, there is a lot, and Surah Al-Tawbah. A lot of description of them, how they behave, what they do, how you know him, how you deal with him. For that, follow with us, inshallah, and stay with the halaqat coming more every Saturday, inshallah. And we ask Allah to bless you, and we ask Allah to accept from us. Inni da'in fa'aminu. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, hamdan bi jami'il mahamid, ala jami'il na'am, hamdan la yatanaha. ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل يا رب العالمين، ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا حي يا قيوم يا أرحم الراحمين، نسألك باسمك الأعظم الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونسألك خير المسألة وخير الدعاء وخير النجاح وخير العلم وخير العمل وخير الثواب وخير الحياة وخير الممات. اللهم ثبتنا وثقل موازيننا، اللهم حقق إيماننا وارفع درجاتنا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الشر وأهله يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم من أرادنا بسوء فاجعل نحره في عنقه، واجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم، وصلت عليهم من لا يخافك ولا يرحمهم، وأخرجنا منها سالمين غانمين معافين منصورين مجبورين يا رب العالمين. اللهم من مكر بنا فامكر به، واجعل مكرهم يحيق بهم ويدمرهم تدميرا، واجعل مكر أولئك هو يبور، واجعل كيدهم في تضليل وتباب، نجعلك في نحورهم ونعوذ بالله من شرورهم يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم، انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، وانصر من نصرنا، واخذل من خذلنا، وحسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، وأفوض أمري إلى الله، إن الله بصير بالعباد، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وجزاكم الله خيرا، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ومن الناس من يعجبك قوله في الحياة الدنيا، ويشهد الله على ما في قلبه وهو ألد الخصام، ويشهد الله على ما في قلبه وهو ألد الخصام، وإذا تولى سعى في الأرض ليفسد فيها ويهلك الحرث والنسل، والله لا يحب الفساد. وإذا قيل له اتق الله أخذته العزة بالإثم، فحسبه جهنم ولبئس المهاد. One of their description, one of their characteristics, حسن القول المعجب الذي يكون له وقع في القول. Their speech, they will please you. Do you remember when I said to you, they will say to you what you want. Description of the munafiq in the Quran Kareem. They will say to you what you like. But in their heart and their mind, completely different. توصيت الله بجعله شاهدا على هذا القول وموثقا له، هذا من أعظم الخيانة على الله عز وجل. He calls Allah to be witness. Some of them they swear by Allah as to that which is in his heart. Because Allah knows what's in the tongue, what he's saying, and Allah knows what's in the heart, Allah knows what's in the mind. Also in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confer المهارة في الجدل وقوة الإقناع لقمع كل معارضة تقف أمامه. They are very strong in argue. This is one of the description in this ayah to the hypocrite. Very strong in argue. The most quarrelsome of the opponent. Find him in front of him 10, he will overcome these 10 people. وَلْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ By what? Not by the truth. By the false and by lying and by going around and from here to there, from up to down. And أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Also in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, if nobody see him, if he's alone, he will do the most mischief thing. And he will corrupt the land. He will do a lot of corruption. When he is ordered to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he ordered to be fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is led by arrogance to more crime and to more wrong. As the ayah saying in the Quran al-Kareem, when you say to him, fear Allah, have more taqwa, stop this, he will get more arrogant. Yes, you say to me that, you will see what will happen to you. You will see what will happen to you. For that جمع بين العمل بالجرائم والتكبر. He combined two things together. Acting with the crime and arrogant. Remember when I told you, Iblis was kicked out of Jannah because of what? Arrogant. Allah ordered him, prostrate yourself to Adam. No, I'm better than him. Looking down to Adam. الكبر بطر الحق وغمت الناس. Refuse the truth, this is the truth. Because this is ayat of Allah. Leave me alone. Take it from the Quran and see by yourself. Read it and learn it. Refusing the truth, this is the arrogant. And Allah talk about munafiqin, they are arrogant. They are too proud. They think, oh, I am higher than everybody. I am very intelligent. Everybody is stupid. No. In front of Allah, you will see. Inshallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, the next time we'll go with more ayat and more qualities, more characteristics of those munafiq. Go to Surah An-Nisa, verse number 138 and 139. And also Surah At-Tawbah, Surah number 9, verse number 53 and verse number 54. And coming more and more and more and more about their qualities, inshaAllah. We ask Allah by His great name to save us from النفاق and to save us from المنافقين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت، وإذا سئلت به أعطيت، وإذا استرحمت به رحمت. يا أرحم الراحمين ارحمنا برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء، نعوذ بك من الشر وأهله يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت وإذا سئلت به أعطيت، اجعلنا مؤمنين مخلصين لا منافقين يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من النفاق والشقاق، يا حي يا قيوم يا أرحم الراحمين. على الله توكلنا. ربنا افتح بيننا وبين قومنا بالحق وأنت خير الفاتحين. رب احكم بالحق وربنا الرحمن المستعان على ما تصفون، وأنت يا الله خير الحاكمين وأحكم الحاكمين. اللهم استر عيوبنا واستر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا وفرج همومنا. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت، عليك توكلت وأنت رب العرش العظيم. ما شاء الله كان وما لم يشأ لم يكن، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. أعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير، وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما وأحصى كل شيء عددا. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شر نفسي وشر الشيطان وشركه وشركه، ومن شر كل دابة أنت آخذ بناصيتها يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلني وأهلي وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصرنا واخذل من خذلنا. اللهم انصر من نصرنا واخذل من خذلنا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من النفاق والمنافقين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اكفنا شرهم بما شئت وكيف شئت يا حي يا قيوم، واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم اجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الشر وأهله يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من النفاق والمنافقين، وارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية يا رب العالمين. اللهم رب جبريل وميكائيل وإسرافيل، فاطر السماوات والأرض، عالم الغيب والشهادة، أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. اللهم اهدنا لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك، إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. اللهم اجعل لي وزراء من أهل الله وخاصته، اشدد بهم أزري وأشركهم في أمري كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا، إنك كنت بنا بصيرا، واجعل في ذلك خيرا كثيرا لا مقطوعا ولا ممنوعا من حيث لا نحتسب يا رب العالمين. وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، وجزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم. أن remember me in your dua. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.